So today we will going to discuss about homeopathy medical officer paper 1 question which is comes in the previous year question. So now we only discuss about first year course, that is our anatomy, physiology and biochemistry portion. And this is the paper 1, and please keep with us because we discuss about all those option and with also explanation. If you like, then like it and share it with your friends. Lateral boundary of cubital fossa is formed by, the options are A. our biceps brachii, B. brachioradialis, C. brachialis, D. pronator teres. So we understand by going to a exam our PPT which you can understand. So in our BD chairs here it is the diagram which is the cubital fossa diagram content. So the content, the right cubital fossa, where the mnemonic which we give, that is MBBR. So which side is lateral and which side is medial, we don't know. So how do we know the lateral side and medial side of this MBBR? So by reading the theory. So how can we know that which part is this is the figure which is come from BD Chauriasia head and neck part 1 book. So here the laterally there is medial border of a brachioradialis is present, whereas medially there is lateral border of a pronator teres. Base is formed by the imaginary line joining in the front of a two epicondyle of the humerus, whereas apex is formed by the downward and it is formed by the area where brachioradialis and pronator teres are crossed to each other. So what is our lateral and medial side, we can now estimate. So those laterally, that is what is present, brachioradialis. So you can see that's why this side is lateral and this side is medial. Then the MBBR is from lateral to medial mnemonic. So now what is our answer should be? Answer would be the lateral boundary of a cubital fossa is formed by brachioradialis. Okay, so our answer we found. With this we also complete the cubital fossa content. So now we go towards the next question. What will be our next question? That is, skin of the nail bed of the ring finger is supplied by which nerve? Option A, lateral half of median and medial half of ulnar. Option B, medial half by median and lateral half by median. Option C, whole by median nerve. Option D, whole by ulnar nerve. Whole by ulnar nerve. So how can we know this? So we can know by going to a figure which is come from BD Chauriasia book 1. So here you can see there is 1, 2, 3 number of three knobs are represented. One for blue color, that is ulnar, and two for radial nerve which is towards the yellow color see our median nerve, whereas red color see our two, that is radial nerve. So how which we discuss, then what is our question is that, so which nerve is a supply. So now we discuss our question. So what is our question given? That our question says that skin of a nail bed of a ring finger is supplied by which nerve. So you can just see and answer it. So first we know what is our ring finger, which is first is the little finger, then this is the ring finger, then this is the mid finger and index finger, last one is a thumb. So ring finger is supplied by which nerve? First thing we should know, what is a lateral side, what is a medial side. The lateral side is by anatomical position we see that those finger, little finger is indicate towards the medial side, whereas the thumb which is indicate towards the lateral side. So our ring finger, that is the lateral, the medial side is supplied by which nerve? That is blue color, that is our ulnar nerve. Whereas the lateral side which is thumb, which is supplied by which nerve? That is our median nerve. So in this way our answer will be, now the answer will be our option A, which is lateral half by median nerve and a medial half by ulnar nerve. Okay, this is our answer. So, okay, you can understand. If any discontinuous or anything you can't understand, please comment us. Then we go to our 84 number question, which says that which of the following is not present in the bed of a stomach. So our options are splenic artery, transverse colon, fourth part of the duodenum, transverse major colon. Here transverse major colon, another is a transverse colon. So what is the question mean? That question mean that the stomach bed, which of the following is not present, not present. So what is our answer will be, so please we go towards the next slide, then we can understand. So here the slide I given. So you can understand from this figure that there is a this is stomach. So below to the stomach bed means stomach which lies on which bed, that is its bed, means the structure which lies posterior to the stomach is known as a stomach bed. Because bed means what? When our posterior back portion is lies, similarly the stomach back portion is lies on which organs. So here the outline, here you can see the left suprarenal gland, then spleen, then left kidney, left side, all those structures you can remember by a mnemonic or any a concept, that is all those structures which is present are the left side, they are enter to this stomach bed. So what are the structures are present? Mainly the structures which are left suprarenal, all left suprarenal, left kidney, then spleen also a left side organ, then pancreas, some part of the pancreas, that is neck and tail. So tail and the neck portion is also, because body is here, and splenic flexure, because splenic flexure, what is it mean? Those transverse column is at the angle at which the transverse column is continue as a descending column at the side of the splenic. So that is, so it is called as a splenic flexure. Then splenic artery, then these are the things are entered to the, and another is a transverse colon and a transverse major colon. Here you can see transverse colon, this part is the transverse colon, whereas this part is transverse colon, and this part is our transverse major colon. So these are the structure. So we can know from here the theory is written that all the structure which separate the stomach from the lesser sac is known as a stomach bed. So stomach bed, the structure which are going diaphragm, left kidney, left suprarenal gland, pancreas, transverse major colon, splenic flexure of colon, and a splenic artery. So these are the structure. So now our answer will be what? So our answer became the stomach bed. So our answer will be fourth part of the duodenum. Then we go towards the next question, that which is our normal position of the uterus. How uterus is present in our body? So uterus is, option A is antiverted or antiplexed. And option B is retroverted or retroflexed. Option C is antiverted or retroflexed. Option D is retroverted or antiverted. So much so easy. How can we find this answer? By going a diagram which is given in your PT2RS first year BHMS book of chapter of the tilting, the forward tilting. Here it is mentioned that in the book that forward tilting of the uterus towards the vagina is known as antiversion, whereas a backward tilting of the uterus towards related to vagina is called as a retroversion. So how it is antiversion and how it is retroflex? Whereas the uterus is slightly flexed at the level of internal OS, this is referred as antiflexion. So what is our answer should be? Answer should be antiversion or retroversion or antiflexion. So you can why I mentioned these two things in the diagram, that this line indicates antiversion, whereas another line antiflexion,
anteflexion represent 125 degree, whereas anteversion is represent at the line of this. So in this way I mark antiverted and antiflexed, that is our option A. Then we go towards the next question, that is there is one sesamoid bone, there is one sesamoid bone is present on the tendon of the peroneus longus. So it is articulated with what? So one sesamoid bone which is present on the tendon of the peroneus longus, related to the tendon of the peroneus longus. So it articulated with what? Talus, calcaneus, navicular or cuboid. So what is our answer should be? Here you can see that it arises from the head of the fibula and then it upper one third and the posterior half of the medial one third of the lateral surface of the fibula. It courses. Then what happened? That this tendon passes deep to the peroneal through the tunnel of a cuboid. So here the cuboid bone is called sesamoid bone. So here after the cuboid bone, it is entered to the lateral side of the base of the metatarsal and is inserted in that metatarsal adjoining to the medial cuneiform bone. So in this way it is inserted at the medial cuneiform and a metatarsal bone at the base, but it changes its angle at the level of a cuboid. So here the cuboid bone is represent the articulation. So our answer will be cuboid bone. Understand? So then we go towards the middle cerebral peduncle. It is formed by what? Middle cerebral peduncle is formed by vestibulocerebellar fiber, parallus, this is pontocerebral fiber, posterior spinal cerebral fiber. So what are the content we first discuss, then we go to the answer.
So you can understand from this figure that the structure which are entered to the middle cerebral peduncle is that the pontocerebral. Here you can see the pontocerebral fiber which entered to the middle cerebral peduncle here. Then the superior cerebral peduncle, which is the contain ventral spinous cerebral tract, whereas the posterior part of the spinous cerebral enter to the posterior peduncle. So in this way the answer.
So what is our answer to be? Our answer became the middle cerebral peduncle. The pontocerebral fiber is entered to the middle cerebral peduncle, whereas the posterior spinal cerebral it is posterior cerebral peduncle, whereas the vestibular cerebral fiber which is in the where it is superior cerebral peduncle. SCP means superior cerebral peduncle. Okay, then we go towards the next question. Next question is comes that the pulmonary vein are four in number. So two on each side, they carry which blood? So carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, carbon peroxide and oxygenated. It is so simple, oxygenated blood. You know well, I don't discuss about it further. Next we go towards the next question, that is which gland is provided secretory fiber from inferior salivary nucleus. So what is our important point here? Secretomotor fiber from inferior salivary nucleus. These two things we should remember. So which gland? Parotid gland is our answer. How it is become? Let's understand. So in this figure you can see that here it is coming from our brain neuroanatomy chapter of cranial nerves. In this chapter you can see that in BD2-RS it is written that inferior salivary nucleus is present in the lower part of the pons just below to the superior nucleus, and the fiber it gives the fiber that is the fiber through glossopharyngeal nerve to the parotid gland. Here the our answer will be parotid gland. So you can see from this figure also, here the figure was given that superior salivary, these figures are represent the salivatory nucleus. Okay, this is our last question of anatomy. All the germ cell, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm are present in which organ? Heart, cornea, tympanic membrane or uretra? So what will be our answer will be? So this is question directly come from our Vidicharya given in text question, that is you can see this is the Vidicharya in text question of the you can see direct question is come to the point, not anything what will be mentioned. So here the answer will be tympanic membrane. Tympanic membrane you only remember it because it is a embryology part, so there will be nothing to be understood. So tympanic membrane is made up of all the germ.
We start our physiology portion of question. So 91, which is says that the total body water can be measured by using even blue, tritium oxide, sucrose and sodium thiosulfate. So what is our answer would be? Now we go towards the semilingam topic, which is given I that due measurement of total body water, which is the soft topic of our compartment fluid compartment of the semilingam topic. So what is our answer would be? So deuterium oxide and tritium oxide when mixed with the fluid in all compartment of all the compartment within few hours of injection, the fluid few hours of injection, what happened? This fluid, this oxide are act as a dye which use in the which you mixed with the plasma of the total body fluid and can found our total body fluid inside our different compartment. So now our answer, we can found the total body weight water can be used by tritium oxide. So option B is our answer. So option B is our answer. Then the next question is that 92, lymphocytes are concerned with which type of immunity? So this question is so much dilemma and a confusion because this question is so much because here the line is lymphocyte. So we know cell mediated immunity, humoral immunity, both are together. Cell mediated in T lymphocyte are used, in the humoral there will be B lymphocyte is used. But here the question is asked lymphocyte, neither T or nor B is written. So what is will be answer we can find? So I use humoral immunity because in the humoral immunity there will be concentration of a lymphocyte is more requirement will be occur. But this thing is not sure. So I hope you understand. If not, then comment box what will be your answer. Then our next question 93 says that pancreatic enzyme secretion. So it is mainly from ductal of a cell. Option B, mainly from acinar cells of a pancreas. Option C, stimulated by pancreatic polypeptide. Option D, stimulated by secretin. So question means that where pancreatic enzyme is secreted. Options are given. So where it is secreted, first we discuss by the semilingam pancreatic chapter introduction. So functional anatomy of exocrine part of the pancreas we discuss. So here it is mentioned that the acinar cell contain the acinar cell, mainly the exocrine part is related to digestive enzyme. So acinar cell present in the lumen of the pancreas contain zymogen granules, which is important for digestive enzyme. So that is our answer will be pancreatic enzyme is secreted mainly from the acinar cell, whereas the ductal sub cell, which is option, which is from the hormone, which secreted the hormone. So here the question is pancreatic enzyme secretion. So our answer will be what? Option B. Okay, thank you. The next question is that clearance value of a substance that is freely filtered but neither be secreted nor be reabsorbed by the kidney will be equal to that. What does mean this question? What is the meaning of this question? Here the question says that in the kidney, the clearance value of a substance. Clearance value of a substance means what? Those substances which neither be secreted by the kidney or nor be reabsorbed in the kidney. It is a freely filtered, means those glomerular filtrated value of that substance is equal to, means when it is filtered, means glomerular filtered, when we intake, then it enter to the kidney and enter to the filtration. So here the options are filtration fraction. Here option B will be glomerular filtration rate. That will be mistake. Glomerular filtration rate or GFR. Option C renal plasma flow. Option D urinary excretion rate of the substance. So what will be its answer? We first discuss. So in the Semolingam kidney chapter, here the answer it is written that a substance measurement of a glomerular filtration rate is done by this clearance value. So a substance which is completely filtered means neither be reabsorbed nor be secreted, which is clearance, which indicate the GFR value of that substance. Means the when a substance we intake and it enter to the our kidney, then what happened when, just example, in the inulin, when it enter in our kidney, it does not secrete or reabsorb in the kidney. Those GFR, means the glomerulus what will be filtered, it will be samely excreted. That's why we can called as this is the value will be equal to the GFR value. And this is important, why? Because in the clinical, when there will be kidney dysfunction, we use dialysis. So in that time we use inulin for the clearance value. And we can find next question, that is 95. When the core temperature of an individual rises more than 41 degrees centigrade, the following changes, what are the following changes occur? Exception means what are the not occur inside in that condition. Option A, heat production is increases. Option B, sweating increases greatly. Option C, central nervous system may malfunction. Option D, person may become poikilothermic. So what is our answer? We discuss by taking the Semolingam explanation, that is when the body temperature increases, what are the mechanism occur inside the body. So when the body increases, the body temperature also increases. When the blood with increased temperature will be occur, it stimulated the hypothalamus. Then what happened in the from the hypothalamus, a stimulus was gone towards the thermoreceptor present in the heat loss center of that hypothalamus in the preoptic nucleus. Then what happened to back the temperature normal, there will be two mechanism occur. One is a promotion of heat loss, prevention of heat production. So now the question is asked that in the question we see the heat production will be increases, so that thing will not occur, heat production will be decreases. So what is our answer will be option A, that is heat production will be decreases, but here the action is written that heat production will be increases, so that will be our answer. So option A is our answer. Okay, our next question will be 96. Which of the following hormone impairs the hydrolysis of a triglyceride into fatty acid? What does mean impairs? Means it decreases the hydrolysis of a triglyceride to fatty acid. Means it increases the deposition of a fatty acid. It does not stimulate the fatty acid. What is fatty acid? Free fatty acid formation. So what are the option given there? In the option A, cortisol. Option B, glucagon. Option C, growth hormone. Option D, insulin. So what will be our answer? Insulin. But these upper four are important for the diabetic, means they causes the fatty acid formation. But here the question is which is decreases the fatty acid formation, means it increases the triglyceride formation, that is insulin. So all thank. After that, another question is that 97, ventricular muscle is activated by which impulse? One is Purkinje system, option B is SA node, option C bundle of His, option D AB node. So what will be our answer? So Purkinje fiber is our answer. Why? Now see, in the Semolingam there will be a diagram of the heart we see. So in the heart you see that the Purkinje fiber, this part which I show in yellow color, so this is the ventricular muscle. So which it is supplied by, you can see easily that is Purkinje fiber. So Purkinje fiber is stimulated the impulse towards the ventricular muscle, whereas the SA node and AB node, they are causes the atricular contraction. So what it will be our answer will be that SA node is the ventricular stimulation is occur by the Purkinje fiber. So answer A will be our occur. Then our next question, that is देन आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट 98 हिस्टोटॉक्सिक हाइपोक्साइड इज सीन इन व्हिच कंडीशन कार्बन मोनोक्साइड पॉइजनिंग सियानाइड पॉइजनिंग शॉक एनीमिया सो व्हाट विल बी योर आंसर सो आवर आंसर वुड बी बाय द सेमुलिंगम वन हियर इट इज रिटन दैट द हिस्टोटॉक्सिक हाइपोक्साइड व्हिच अकर इन द वे व्हेन देयर विल बी टिश्यू इज यू डज नॉट ability to utilize the oxygen. What does it mean? Means oxygen is sufficient. Hemoglobin is sufficient. But tissue does not uptake it. Why? Because of that cyanide. So what is due to the cyanide or sulfide poisoning, there will be histotoxic hypoxia occur. And one thing we should remember that cyanide poisoning is by which the hypoxia, which is only the histotoxic hypoxia. Other hypoxia, there will be no cyanide poisoning condition will be occur. So our answer cyanide. So our answer will be cyanide poisoning, that is option B. Other two option I also discussed that in the carbon monoxide poisoning and shock is responsible for the stagnant hypoxia, whereas anemia is due to the anemic hypoxia. So our answer we find also we discussed the option other options. Okay. Now the next question that is 99 intestinal absorption of calcium due to active uptake, due to simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, or endocytosis. So in the active uptake there will be ATP requirement is occur. In the simple diffusion there will be requirement of pressure gradient. Whereas in the facilitated diffusion what happened? There will be a carrier requirement. There will be a protein carrier requirement. So how can we know what will be the answer? Now we go towards the Semolingam topic of diffusion. That is in the biochemistry part U Satarana. There will be written that the calcitar makes the calcium binding protein, which is helpful for the intestinal absorption of calcium. That's why there will be requirement of a calcium binding protein. So we can call it as a protein channel is required. So it is a answer will be C, that is facilitated diffusion. Now the next question that is 100 and the last question that is in human being primary auditory center is cortex is present in where? Option A, area number 44. Option B, area number 41. Option C, area number 43. Option D, area number 22. So what will be our answer? Going towards the Semolingam chapter of auditory cortex, that is primary auditory area. So 41 and 42, which is Renix area, which is responsible for primary auditory sensation. Whereas audio psychic sensation by auditory area 22. So what will be our answer? 41. Here the option given in the 41. So 41 and 42, which is situated at the anterior transverse gyrus and the lateral surface of a superior temporal gyrus, which is known as the Renix area, at the upper part of a superior temporal gyrus, posterior to the 41 and 42. So that's why this is our answer. So Renix area, that is 41, 42, or option B.